In a previous video, I demonstrated how my smart home automatically detected member presence when we arrived at our smart home. Setting up your smart hub to automatically detect your family's presence or lack thereof is a very useful feature. Having this capability not only allows you to seamlessly arm and disarm your home, but you can also use presence detection routines to trigger a number of useful automations. Such automations include turning on lights, opening a garage door, or unlocking an exterior door. Stay tuned to learn how to set up smartphone presence detection in the SmartThings app. Welcome to Bud's Smart Home, where we provide SmartThings related news, practical smart home automations, and reviews of compatible SmartThings devices. If this sort of content appeals to you, then be sure to tap on that subscribe button. This will allow you to receive notifications when I publish more smart home content. Now, if I chose my favorite smart home automation, I would have to say it is the routines that enable our home to be automatically armed when we depart and disarmed when we return home. Actually, I believe this is the single best automation for any smart home. Not only is it an awesome security feature, it also provides the added convenience of seamlessly setting the appropriate security mode each time members depart and return home. Now, before I relay any details about the setup of presence detection, I want to make a brief disclaimer. Although the automations that I'll share with you today work for me, I will not guarantee that they'll work for everyone. There are simply too many variables that could affect successful setup, namely the vast number of smartphones and smartphone operating systems. Smartphones are a critical component of presence detection. Assuming that your phone can be used as a reliable sensor, there are other essential items that are important for successful setup. First, you absolutely must have a SmartThings or AOTech smart hub. You must also ensure that the SmartThings app is correctly installed on each participating member's smartphone. You must also ensure that all permissions are enabled on each member's phones. And then you must also have a compatible operating system installed on your phone. I'll provide you with my personal experience with an incompatible operating system in just a bit. So just know that there are too many issues that could affect your ability to set up reliable presence detection within the SmartThings app. I cannot address all of these exceptions in this episode. So with that proviso made, I will now explain the SmartThings setup that works for me. To enable presence detection, I simply added a home location and then I defined my geolocation in the SmartThings app. Once my home's location and geolocation were set, I then added each family member's device to the SmartThings app via an invitation link. Finally, I gave SmartThings permission to get the location of each member's phone. I'll leave links below where you can access the steps for adding a location and a geolocation, and also links for the steps for adding and managing family members in the SmartThings app. It is vital that all members go into their SmartThings app and allow the setting titled Get Your Location from This Phone. This can be enabled by going to the hamburger menu in the SmartThings app, which is situated in the bottom right-hand corner. Tap on the hamburger menu, then tap on the gear icon in the top right. Next, tap on the phrase, Get Your Location from This Phone, and ensure that you toggle the switch on for your location. It's also important that you find the setting titled Notifications in the Settings menu and ensure that you allow notifications as well. Finally, it's vital that you go into your personal smartphone notification settings specific to the SmartThings app and enable the setting to always allow notifications. Once the SmartThings app is set up properly in all member smartphones, your next task is to write a couple of SmartThings routines to arm and disarm your home based on the presence or lack of presence of member phones. I have a total of 4 routines that I use to change the mode of my home. I have good night, good morning, goodbye, and I'm back routines that switch my SmartThings home monitor between the available security modes of arm, disarm, and arm stay. I'm not going to get into the specifics of how I use the good night and good morning modes. Rather, in today's episode, I'll only summarize the goodbye routine, which arms our home, and the I'm back routine, which disarms our home. both my goodbye and I'm back routines use the SmartThings member location as the routine trigger. The SmartThings and SmartThings AOTech hubs are equipped to detect each member's location based on each phone's proximity to the hub's geolocation. The geolocation is simply an invisible GPS circle generated by your hub, which encircles your smart home. The goodbye routine is written to instruct the hub to use the location of all member phones. If all members are found to be absent from the home's geolocation, the routine instructs the hub to change the location's mode to away. It also instructs the hub to change the SmartThings home monitor to armed away. Conversely, the I'm back routine instructs the hub to use member location to determine when any single member returns home. When member presence is detected by the hub sets the location mode to home, and it also sets the SmartThings home monitor to disarmed. You may also have noted that I also have both routines set up to send notifications to all members. As such, every member is alerted when our home is disarmed or when it's set to armed away. Previously, I mentioned that a phone's operating system could affect your ability to use a phone as a reliable presence sensor. If you or certain members of your family have older smartphones, you will likely be unable to use them to establish reliable presence detection. I have found that older iOS devices do not work reliably within SmartThings as presence sensors. I previously owned an iPhone 7. Presence detection on the iPhone 7 was extremely unreliable. However, after I upgraded to an iPhone 14, my smartphone presence detection now works flawlessly. I initially discovered this when my wife upgraded from an iPhone 6 to an iPhone 11. We noticed that our iPhone 11 worked extremely well as a presence sensor, whereas the iPhone 6 was hit or miss. It is my personal belief that older Apple phones may not work reliably as presence sensors because they do not have the ability to use the latest iOS version. In June 2022, Apple announced that it would drop support for iPhone 7 and 7 Plus with the release of iOS 16. The maximum available version of iOS on the iPhone 7 is iOS version 15.7.2. Although I am not an authority on Android devices, what I can tell you is that the newest operating system for the Android phone is also working reliably for presence detection in the SmartThings app. Previously, I made a couple of videos about virtual presence sensors, and that has led to some confusion about their role within the SmartThings app. Allow me to take a moment to talk about virtual presence switches. Some of you may be asking yourself why I took time to present virtual presence switches in these former videos. You may also be wondering if you need them in your SmartThings app. Well, that, my friend, is a matter of preference. You certainly do not need them to change the modes of your SmartThings home monitor. You may, however, want them if you prefer the ability to use a member's status within a third-party app, such as SharpTools or Alexa. Allow me to explain. First off, I have an article on my website, to which I'll link in the description below this video. In that article, you will find a channel invitation for accessing Edge-compatible virtual presence switches. That invitation will allow you to enable virtual presence sensors within your SmartThings app. When you add a virtual presence switch, you gain the ability to detect when specific members arrive or depart from your geolocation. Each individual member must have a virtual presence switch, and each virtual presence switch must be controlled by at least two routines. The purpose of these two routines is to turn the virtual presence switch on or off based on each member's arrival or departure. So when my virtual presence device, which I called iPhone Bud, is away from our geolocation, the routine instructs the hub to turn off my virtual presence switch. And when I return, a second routine turns my virtual presence switch on. So the usefulness of virtual presence switches in the SmartThings app is to have a visual representation of each member's status, whether they're home or away. However, virtual presence switches become especially useful when they're used to trigger routines in third-party apps, namely Alexa or SharpTools. Without virtual presence switches, you'll not have the ability to see a member's status in these third-party apps. However, with virtual presence switches, you can instruct your Alexa app to make an Echo announcement specific to any one member. You can also use a member virtual presence switch in a SmartThings routine to turn on specific smart devices or to run a scene that is personalized for that specific member. So I hope this episode has helped demystify some of the confusion surrounding presence detection in the SmartThings app. If this video was helpful and you consider it worth your time, I ask that you take the time to convey your appreciation with a like or with a comment. Either way, please know that I appreciate each and every one of you, and I wish for you the very best smart home on the block. Hey, thanks for joining me today, and as always, keep automating and God bless.